first of all, thank you for coming here. Thank you for recognizing Polish American Congress as the leading organizations in our community. As you had a chance to speak with our folks minutes ago, see, Poland's security is very important, not only for Poles in Poland, but Polish Americans here in the United States. And it was mentioned that since American Revolution War, Polish soldiers always fought with United States. So I'm going to ask you two very important questions for as the commander-in-chief, would you protect your closest allies? Will you respect Article 5 of the NATO Treaty? And how do you plan to implement the 2016 Warsaw NATO Summit agreement to deploy NATO armed forces from Western Europe and United States to Baltic states and Poland?
All right. First of all, I have to tell you that I have great respect for the Polish people. Many, many friends that I have who are Polish and some who come from Poland and live currently in Poland. So the Polish people are amazing people, and Poland is a great country, and we will protect Poland. That you can be sure of. If I become president, we will have protection for Poland and for the Polish people, and you can bank on that. That's 100% positive.
Will you be sending more armed forces, more troops to Poland and the Baltic states?
Well, we're going to be working very closely with NATO, as I feel we absolutely have to. And Poland is one of the countries that's actually up to date in terms of what their obligations are, which is very nice to see. But we'll be working with NATO, but we will protect Poland.
As you may know, 6 years ago, Poles as a nation experienced a tragedy in a plane crash. Polish President Lech Kaczyński, his wife, and other political leaders were killed. The Polish government has not been able to get from Russia the wreckage of the plane as well as the black boxes. So based on your friendly rhetoric about President Putin, if the Polish government will ask you, are you willing to intervene?
Well, I would be. If I become president, I would certainly speak to. This is something that I've been hearing about, and for some reason, they haven't been able to get it. And if I become president, I would certainly intervene and do the best I can to help you.
Mr. Trump, you have mentioned several times that it's not going to be a mercy for undocumented immigrants in this country. Among the 11 million undocumented immigrants are Polish immigrants who work, have businesses, have American-born children, pay taxes. So you would still tell them, we will deport you?
We are a tremendous country. We will be doing things through the laws, through legal immigration. We'll be having our immigration system very much upgraded so that people that have been waiting online for many years that we want to have come in, because I want people to come into our country, but we all want them to come in legally. And we will be doing a very massive upgrade of the system of coming in so that people can, in fact, come into our country. We're a land of immigrants. We're a land of people coming in. And we will be working on that, and people will be able to come into our country legally. And that certainly includes Polish people.
Coming back to the security, you have a great plan for America's internal security, law and order. But when it comes to international politics, you often say that United States shouldn't be a policeman of the world. So how you think that you can defend the leadership role of the United States?
Well, it's really going to be on a case-by-case basis. I'm very, very strong on the military, as you know. We want to build up our military. Our military is very depleted at a time when we most need it. So we're going to build up our military. We're going to make it very strong again. And nobody will be pushing us around, and nobody will be pushing our allies and our friends around. That I can tell you.
Do you have a special message for Polish-American voters in this country?
Well, I do. I've had just tremendous relationships over my lifetime with Polish people. I understand Polish people, and I love the Polish people, and I think I will get every single vote. I think the Polish people are going to be voting for Donald Trump, and they know that, look, I care for them. They're an amazing group of people, hardworking people, so intelligent, and I feel an obligation to protect everyone, but I do feel a special, really just a great obligation to help the Polish people. And you know, you have a lot of problems right now with the relationships with this country. You're having a lot of problems with between Poland and the United States, as you know, and bureaucratic problems largely where you can't get anything done. When I'm president, that will end.
You just mentioned seconds ago that you will mention Poland during your campaign.
Yes.
And then we pay our bills for NATO, and we are great supporters. And also you mentioned the visa waiver program, that it's going to take weeks when you become president that this issue is going to be solved.
Well, so many countries have the visa waiver program, and they've got it. Many countries. And I'm going to find out why Poland doesn't have it. I'm going to start looking at that right away. But we have so many countries that have that program, and why wouldn't Poland have it? So I'm going to work on that immediately.
Thank you very much. We are not going to keep you longer than is possible.
Thank you.
But it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Appreciate it.